Hi, I'm Steve Sandler, the Managing Director and CTO at Picotest. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use a unique control loop stability tool that, thanks to Heidi Barnes, is now available for Keysight's PathWave ADS simulator. Every power supply has at least one control loop, and every control loop requires a stability assessment. The need for assessment may be dictated by a corporate or government guideline, by a statement of work, but just because it's good engineering practice. Modern circuits are making this much more challenging, and that is what makes this video valuable. In many modern applications, power management ICs, or PMICs, are used to generate multiple power rails. This ST Microelectronics demo board is a good example. The PMIC includes 14 power rails, 4 buck regulators, a switching boost regulator, 6 LDOs, and a DDR termination regulator. There are 2 separate challenges to determining the stability of these 14 voltage regulator control loops. First, none of the 14 power rails provide access to their respective control loops. Second, the buck regulators in this PMIC, and in most PMICs, use adaptive constant on-time control. Constant on-time provides excellent transient response, but it's neither linear nor time invariant, which are 2 necessary conditions for stability analysis using traditional Bode plots. Since we always have access to an output capacitor, I developed a fast, simple, and non-invasive stability margin analysis tool, NISM for short, using the voltage regulator's output impedance. This NISM calculation is a popular function on many network analyzers, and as shown in this video, it's now available in the PathWave ADS EDA tool. Here you can see the measured output impedance plot at one of the 6 LDO output caps in this PMIC. You can also see that NISM reports the phase margin stability of the control loop is 49 degrees. The control loop stability is computed directly from the impedance versus frequency data. The only requirement is access to an output capacitor. This Sandler NISM stability analysis tool is now available for ADS, and it's free. That's the focus of today's video. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use this Sandler Non-Invasive Stability Margin tool, or NISM, in ADS to determine control loop stability. I'll show you a little theory about how NISM works, some functional limitations, and I'll also share some of my best tips. At the end of the video, I'll show you where to download the workspace and how to install it as a template so that you can use it on simulated and measured data to evaluate your own circuits. The impedance data required for NISM stability assessment can be obtained from either measurement or from simulation. For this video's example ADS workspace, we're going to use the Picotest LM20143 regulator demo board set. This demo board set is readily available and provides access for both traditional Bode plot gain phase data and also for the Sandler non-invasive stability margin impedance data. These boards are also very simple to use, requiring only a USB cable for input power. Even the load resistors are included on the board. And we know the right answer. So if you decide to try this NISM measurement yourself, you'll know if you got the right answer right away. The ADS data display template equation page shows that the impedance data is post-processed by an encrypted AEL script. The Sandler NISM AEL script returns a transformed QTG parameter versus frequency. 2 markers, M1 and M2, are placed on the appropriate impedance and QTG peaks. The AEL script processes the data and returns the NISM phase margin result. Date and timestamps are created to help with the documentation and revision control. The ADS NISM data plots show the impedance data on the left axis as well as the calculated QTG parameter on the right axis. Marker M1 is placed on the impedance peak and marker M2 is placed on the QTG peak. The calculation display shows the calculated NISM phase margin. The display also provides the frequency of each marker and the effective QTG magnitude for marker M1. This works the same as it does on a network analyzer, but in ADS it can be used on both measured and simulated impedance results. The example NISM plots shown here are for the LM20143 buck regulator with 2 different PC board decoupling designs. The one on the left has an impedance that's non-flat with a resonant peak that results in poor stability. The data on the right is for a flat impedance design with no resonant impedance peaks and greater than 65 degrees stability. That's it. It's really quite simple. Now let me show you a little bit about how NISM works and some tips on how to use it. NISM accurately determines the quality factor, or QTG, of the impedance by evaluating the first derivative, or slope, of the impedance phase versus frequency. This information, along with the frequency shift between the impedance peak and the QTG peak, are used to mathematically separate the impedance into the voltage regulator's active output impedance and the fixed output capacitor impedance. With these two known, the traditional oscillator theory minor loop gain assessment is used to accurately compute the stability margin. NISM is an exact solution for the stability margin, also known as the closest point to the singular instability at 1,0 on a Nyquist circle. The NISM calculated stability margin is then transformed to the equivalent second-order phase margin as the resulting output. The step load response, whether a control loop is critically damped, overdamped, or underdamped, is also related to this stability margin. In my university research work, I compared a wide range of solutions using Bode plot simulations of a second order control loop and the NISM solution, confirming the exactness of the solution. Simulation was used to provide noise-free data and to eliminate errors associated with interconnects and signal injection. A similar comparison between measured Bode plots and NISM measurements yielded consistent results well within 1 degree. The most important tip for using the Sandler NISM stability assessment is to find the correct impedance peak and QTG peak. This is done by comparing the control loop power to on and power off impedances. The impedance peak caused by the output capacitor resonating with the control loop active output inductance is the correct peak for the M1 marker. This peak is visible in the on state of the blue trace but disappears in the off state of the green dash trace. M2 is then placed on the red trace QTG peak that's closest to the frequency of the M1 impedance peak. NISM can also be applied to measurement data, to simulated data results using my Sandler state space voltage regulator model, or even to simulated data from the simplified voltage regulator RL models. NISM also works on the input impedance of a voltage regulator. The input filter stability, often referred to as the Middlebrook criteria, like NISM, is a minor loop assessment, so NISM works there as well, and you don't need to separate the input filter from the VRM. The plot on the left shows an input filter design on the LM20143 regulator that has a high impedance at 1 kHz and 40 degrees of stability. However, turning the regulator on with this input filter shows how the active negative input resistance of the regulator reduces the stability down to 17 degrees. The goal of a quality power delivery network design is to achieve flat impedance. So how do we assess the stability when there's no peak? You just pat yourself on the back. You did a great job. Your design is very stable. Some voltage regulators, for example, constant on-time converters, are not linear and time invariant, and these are two prerequisites for Bode plot assessment. In these cases, Bode plots will not provide a reliability stability assessment. A closed-loop measurement will, and NISM is a closed-loop measurement. Thus, NISM will work in these cases where the Bode plot will fail. One note, Bode plots for higher-order converters like CEPIX will not correlate well with NISM. However, NISM is still a better stability assessment than the Bode plot in these cases. In this video, I showed you how to use impedance to calculate voltage regulator stability, how to use the Sandler NISM algorithm and Keysight's PathWave ADS-EDA tool, some tips on using the regulator on and off states to find the active inductance peak of the regulator output impedance, and how NISM also works for the regulator input filtering. Remember that this unique NISM assessment does not require access to the voltage regulator's control loop. It works with constant on-time control loops where traditional Bode plots fail. It works with measured and simulated data, and it's free to download for use with Keysight's PathWave ADS. You can download this workspace, including the NISM data display template, by clicking on the link in the description of this video, or by typing in this URL. This is the sixth video in the How to Design for Power Integrity series. If you haven't watched the prior videos yet, you might want to go ahead and do that. In prior How to Design for Power Integrity videos, we showed how rogue waves can occur if impedance isn't flat. We showed how poor VRM control loop stability can also result in an unflat impedance. We showed how to measure and model capacitors, and we showed how to select capacitors to achieve flat impedance.